Hey guys, this is a Progroholic, and today I'm here to help you in taking the first steps into the programming. So basically it's better for you to start with a C programming language if you are new to the programming. So what are the basic requirements for you to start programming? Number one, you need a compiler to write your program and convert it into machine language. A machine can only understand a machine language, which is zeros and ones. Okay, it's a binary language. There are no other characters except zero and one in this language. So the code that you write in either C or Java or C++ or any other language, that should be converted into machine language so that the your PC or any other computer can understand what you have written. So number one, the compiler, which converts your language into the machine language. And number two, any text editor. You can also use a notepad to write your programs, but I recommend you to use notepad++ because it will give you a nice interface. I'll show you how notepad++ looks like. In all my videos I always use notepad++ to write programs, so you can go and have a look at those videos to see how this text editor looks like. And that's it. Lastly, you need some programming knowledge, which I'm going to give you. And now for the first step, we are going to install the compiler for C language. Open your web browser and go to equation.com. Here you will find the GCC compiler, which is GNU compiler collection, which is used to compile your C language. So on the left side you can see programming tools. Go ahead and click programming tools, and under programming tools you will be able to see Fortran, C, C++, debugger, make, GNU compliance. Click Fortran, C, C++, which is the first link in this list. So go ahead and click Fortran, and in the middle of the page you can see all this stuff. And when you scroll down, you will be able to see download official releases, and here you have all the versions of GCC compilers which you can download on your system. To know what operating system you are running, you can directly go to your this PC or my computer based on the version of Windows. If it is Windows 10 or Windows 8.1, you will be able to see this PC. If it is Windows 8 or Windows 7, you will see computer or my computer. So right click on the my computer window or this PC window, and you will be able to see properties. So go to the properties. Okay, go to properties, and here you will see the details of your operating system. And in here you can see the system type, which is a 64-bit operating system, which is mine. So as my system is of 64-bit, I'm going to download the latest version, which is 5.3.0 GCC. So I'm just clicking on this gcc.exe, and you will be asked to download the file. I have Internet Download Manager, so that thing will grab all the downloads that I have to take. If you don't have this download manager, you will be directly getting a window called Save As, and you can give the name to that, and wherever you want to save it, you can save it even on the desktop. So my path will be in programs, my downloads folder, and in download folder there is a folder called programs. In that folder my setup file will be downloaded. When I have downloaded the GCC, it was a 5.2.4. I think it has released after I have downloaded, but 5.2.0 is not bad. You can download any of the versions you have over there. So now I'm going to run this setup file. I don't know if you can see this window, but I can see a user account control giving a warning that do you want to allow this app from unknown publisher to make changes to your PC. Go ahead and press yes, and it'll give you this window which says extracting. I think it takes time, so I'll come back when the extraction completes. So immediately after the extraction is complete, you will be asked whether to accept this license agreement. So just go ahead and click accept, and it will give you path where the compiler is going to be installed. But I recommend you to remove all of this and create a folder directly under C, which is min gw, in which a mgw are uppercase. So what this does is nothing but it will create a folder called min gw, and in that folder your compiler will be installed. So go ahead and click install, and immediately after this installation is done, you will get a window that says congratulations, GCC has been successfully installed. Please log off and log in again to affect the settings GCC have been configured for all users. Now I have logged off and logged in again, so let us check whether the GCC or the compiler which we have installed is installed properly. Press Windows plus R, which gives you a run command, which is over here, and type cmd, alright, and click OK. And you will be able to see a command prompt. This is where we are going to compile our C programs. So we are going to check whether the GCC which we have installed is correctly configured and working. So just type GCC and press enter. You will see GCC fatal error, no input files. It is giving you message that says you have not given any input file to compile. So that means GCC has installed successfully. When you are trying to compile something, you can directly go to GCC space the file which you have written your program in. For example, let me say myprogram.c. When you press enter now, it will give you the output of that program if you have that file. But I have not written any program, so it says myprogram.c, no such file or directory found. So to write the program, you need a text editor. So let's directly go to the browser, and in the Google search you can type notepad. Okay, it's over here, notepad plus plus. All right. So let's just go to the first link, which says notepad++ home, and with the link http notepad++.org. So click notepad++ home. So this is how the website looks like. Now on the left side, you will be able to see a download link. So just go ahead and click download. The latest version is 6.8.8. So when you scroll down, you will be able to see a link that says download. Go ahead and click download here, and you will be seeing a window, and just say start download. And I already have this downloaded, so I'm not going to download it again. This is the application which I have downloaded long ago. You can directly go and install it. You select your language and say okay, next, agree, and this is the path where I have installed the application. So go next, and it is better for you if you check all the options given or everything in the list. So go ahead and click next. And this thing, don't change anything on it. If you want a shortcut on desktop, you can click here, but don't go to this thing. It already said it could cause security issue. Turn it on if you know what you're doing. So if you don't know what you're doing, please don't go to it. So click install, but I have already installed it, so I'm not going to install it again. So I'm going to cancel this thing. And when you open this notepad++ window, you will see something like this. Yep, these are all the programs that I have written. So in here we are going to write a new C program. So I'm going to click file, new, and file, save as. I'm going to go to desktop for now, and I'm going to create a new folder if you're able to see it. Otherwise, let me just click here. This is new folder, so just C programs. I'm going to name it like that. Alright, in here I'm going to save this file. So let me say it is my first. It's better to start a next word with a capital letter or uppercase letter. So my first program without space. All right, remember that. And you can see a bunch of options from which you can choose C source file, so it will automatically put my first program.c. save it. I'm writing a basic program to print hello world on the console. You don't worry about what I'm writing, I will explain everything in the next video. For now, this tutorial is only to install the application or the compiler and compile and execute a small code. So let me do this. So this is the basic program that I have written. So let me see if the GCC is working properly. CD space desktop, and in the desktop we have a program, folder, it says C programs. In here we have my first program.c. So I'm just going to type GCC space my first program.c. if you if you type the first letter or first two letters or something and press tab button, it will automatically generate all the possible files in that folder with letter M. So I'm going to press enter. Alright, now we have compiled the program that I have written, and the output doesn't come now. Compilation is just converting your code into the machine language, but now we have to execute application which you have created. So let me go to the desktop. In C programs, I have just created this folder, and in this folder I have saved this .c file. But where did this a.exe come from? This came when I have compiled the program. If you want, I can compile this again. So I'm going to delete this thing. I'm going to put this window open in the background, and here you will be able to see the changes that are going to take place in this folder. So I'm going to compile this thing again, and you will see a.exe. So you can execute this a.exe from here, I mean double clicking this one, or writing a and hello world. But if you directly open this thing, it will just open it and close within a fraction of a second. What do we have to do if we want to look at the window, if you don't want that window to close before you see anything happening in it? There's a simple command which says getch. At the end of the program, you can write that and save it and compile that again. So you have to compile the program every time you make changes, okay? So let me do this again, and look at this. Now it won't close until you say, alright? Let me clarify this thing. If you write any other program and compile this again, the old a.exe will be overwritten by the new a.exe. That means application that you have written before will be overwritten by the new application. So it is always a best practice to rename your files immediately after creating them. So I'm writing something like hello world. Alright. So if you open it, you will be able to see that. If you compile that program again, you will be creating a new a.exe, which does not overwrite the old application. Let me say, alright, so I'm just giving my second rogue dot C, I mean where is C? Alright, so my second program dot C, I'm just going to copy this thing. I'm going to make a little changes in that. In the second program, let me say hi YouTube. So in this folder, a.exe already says hello world, which is my previous application. Let me say I have sat for a whole day and written hundreds of lines of code and created a small console application, and the compiler automatically generates it and gives it a name A. I have forgotten to change the name, and by mistake I have compiled the second program that I have written. So see what happens. So let me say my, and if you press tab, keep pressing tab, it will show all the possible files with that name, with that with my at the starting. It is going to overwrite the a.exe, and if you open it, there is no more hello world. So that is very disastrous if you write a very long code. So it is always a best habit to rename your file immediately after compiling. So let me say hi YouTube. So when you press hello world.exe, you will say hello world, and if you say hi YouTube.exe, it will say hi YouTube. So that is a good habit to rename your compiled applications. That's all for today, guys. I hope you have learned things, and I will give this code in the description so that you can test it. And that's all, guys. Have a nice time. Please subscribe, share, and make your own experiment. Bye-bye.